Proactive Investors' John Harrington's with me in the studio this afternoon. John, nice to see you. Welcome along.
Good afternoon.
Big day for CityFibre. Shares up by almost a quarter in early deals this morning. This is on the back of their tie-up with Vodafone.
Yeah.
Tell me a bit more about what's involved here.
It's basically, they are a company that does kind of like broadband networks. And that's an expensive proposition, but they've managed to kind of get an agreement with Vodafone, who are going to enter into a partnership for what is a fairly massive, what they call fibre to the premises project. So from what I remember, in fact, you probably remember this better than me, you know, it's going to come in like two phases.
Mm-hmm.
The first phase is going to connect up about a dozen or so cities where CityFibre are already represented.
About a million homes.
About a million homes, yeah. And then I think there's a second phase, which may, you know, extend beyond that, to cover about 20% of the entire broadband market in the UK. So it's a big deal. What Vodafone's involvement is, they've basically said, if you give us 5 years exclusivity, you know, we will definitely take the, I don't know what you call it, the pipelines, the network capacity. You know, so that's kind of like underwritten it, really. But yeah, it is a lot of money. I think it's about £500 to £700 million mm-hmm. in capital expense for CityFibre to spend out. And they're only, you know, the market cap's only about £375 million. So it is a very big deal for them.
A big deal for them. How do you reckon BT Openreach is going to react to this?
Well, that's interesting, because BT Openreach is like the, you know, the broadband arm of BT. It's now being kind of run at arm's length at the behest of the government. And about a couple of weeks ago, I think it was, they actually put out a consultation document where they'd spoken to all the main internet service providers, except for the cable companies, who've already got their own fibre networks. And they said, look, you know, we could spend a humongous amount of money connecting this super fast network to the homes, increased broadband speeds and all that. Do you fancy helping us out? And they said, yeah, we definitely will take that capacity. We're not quite so keen on paying for it. So as is the way with BT, you know, ex-nationalised industry, had done a consultation document. It's kind of like slow moving, and they put the results of that consultation document out there and more or less put it in the government's hands and said, well, you know, if you can kind of finance it or subsidise it or whatever, then it will happen. What's quite interesting about CityFibre is they've just gone out and found a wealthy partner and said, well, we're just going to kick on and do it. And in the words of the Field of Dreams, isn't it? If you build it, they will come. So that's their plan.
Broadly speaking here, how important do you reckon this is for the British economy? Of course, broadband speeds have long been a source of frustration for consumers.
Yeah, it is. I don't know about you, but you know, if I move home, that's one of the first things I look at now is like broadband speed. People working from home, it's just so much is done online that it is just become part of the national infrastructure. Just as you need good roads, you need good you know, railway systems and all that sort of stuff, broadband is just as important, if not more important. What we're finding is increasingly that the companies that serve in this market, you know, the fibre network providers, obviously they're going to go where the people are, you know, the intensely populated urban conurbations. So it's great news if you live in one of these dozen cities, the initial run, and the 25, 50 cities that are projected by 2025.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe not such great news if you're living in Inverness or Lowestoft or somewhere a little bit more kind of off the beaten track. For those guys, it's not such good news, but they will probably have to use things like satellite communications companies. And there's a couple of those around that do specialise in, well, some of them specialise in giving broadband to airplanes and ships. But, you know, the same basically principle will work for people in the Outer Hebrides, I guess.
But of course, for those out in slightly more remote locations, it's about the lifestyle, I'm sure, many would argue.
Well, I can't comment because I've always lived, you know, in a town. But I get very, very grumpy when my youngest son starts playing his computer games and it slows my broadband speed down. So, yeah, if my town is one of the cities CityFibre's coming to, I'll be signing up PDQ.
Brilliant. John, good to see you as always. Thank you.
Anyway.